NextLabs Data Access Enforcer, or DAE, can be used by organizations to address their data privacy challenges. Data privacy challenges can be complex, both because there are regulations that vary depending on the geographic locations an organization is operating in, as well as because data privacy risk can be specific to the type of data and the environment an organization is operating in. In addition to regulatory risks, there are also reputational and legal liability risks to an organization if private data is breached. Ensuring data privacy is made more challenging by the increasingly global and distributed workforces that many organizations have today. Employees are accessing private data from many different environments and from geographic locations that may be subject to different data privacy requirements. Global supply chains and distribution networks also increase the data privacy risks faced by organizations. Every time data is shared with another individual or organization, it increases the chances of that data getting into the wrong hands. All of these complexities can increase the cost of implementing data privacy controls. NextLabs dynamic authorization technology allows organizations to define data privacy policies using attribute-based access control, or ABAC, which allows policies to be evaluated at the time of data access, meaning that changes to user and data attributes will automatically be incorporated into policy evaluation. We will demonstrate three ways DAE can be used to improve data privacy. First, we will show how DAE can be used to mask bank account details for business partners based on a user's role and geographic region. Next, we will show how access to inventory records can be limited to only the users who need to access that data. And finally, we will show how employee PII can be masked to anyone who is not in HR for that employee's region. In this example, we will see how DAE can be used to mask bank account details based on the department and the region of the user who is requesting those details. We will also show how different fields can be masked or unmasked independently of each other, depending on the user characteristics. Here, we will limit the bank account details to only users who are in the same region, and we will limit the access to the account number to only users in the finance department. So to show this, we have three users. The first user is based in the United States and is a member of the finance department, and so we'll be able to view both the bank key and the bank account number for all U.S. accounts. The second user is based in the U.S., but is a member of the development department, so they will only be able to view the bank key, but not the account number for U.S. accounts. And the final user is based in Germany, and so they will have both the bank key and the account number for U.S. accounts masked. First, we'll take a look at how this policy is defined in the NextLabs Control Center. Here we have created a policy to mask customer bank account information. We specify that the policy applies to all users. And then we can specify the data masking conditions. Here we are actually defining two things that should be masked. One is a partial mask of the bank identifier, bank L. And the other is a full mask of the bank account number. Both of the mask conditions use data that is found within the SAP database. The bank identifier will be masked for users that are from a different country, where the country code does not match that of the bank account. And then the bank account number will be masked if the user does not have the same country code, as well as if the user is not a member of the finance department. Now let's see how this looks in the SAP system. First, we are viewing the business partner record as the citizen US user, who is both a citizen of the United States as well as a member of the finance department. As you can see, for them, US bank accounts are unmasked for both the bank key and the bank account number, while bank accounts for other countries, such as Germany or Hungary, are fully masked. Next, we'll see how this looks for the citizen US 2 user. This user is a citizen of the US, but is not a member of the finance department. So for them, the bank keys are unmasked, but the bank account numbers are still masked. Both the German and the Hungarian bank accounts are fully masked. Finally, we'll view this as the user citizen DE, or the German citizen user. This user is a German citizen and a member of the finance department, so they will see German bank accounts, bank keys, and bank accounts unmasked, while both the US and the Hungarian bank accounts are still fully masked. This concludes our demo of using DAE to mask business partner bank account information. In this example, we will see how DAE can be used to limit user access to inventory records. Specifically, we will use the user attributes of company and ID and location, and the data attributes of company and storage location to limit the inventory records shown to a user to be those that match their location. We will look at two users in this example. First, the citizen US, who is in location 171A, and will therefore only be able to see the inventory records in the storage location of 171A. The second user, citizen US2, has a location of 171B, and will only be able to view the inventory in storage location 171B. First, we will take a look at how this policy is defined in the NextLabs Control Center. Here we have a policy that filters the inventory data based on company code and storage location. This policy applies to all users, and we define the resource attributes, so the table and the database and the server that these apply to. In the predicate condition, here's where we define how the user company ID and the storage location should be used to filter the records. Note that this data and these values are being pulled dynamically from the SAP database in order to filter the records. Now let's look at how this is applied in the SAP system. First, we can see the inventory data as shown to the citizen US user. This is the user that has the location of 171A, and you can see that the inventory is filtered to only show those the storage location of 171A. Now, if we view the same table with the citizen US2 user, who has the location of 171B, we can see that the inventory data is filtered to only show the inventory in location 171B. This concludes the demonstration of using user and data attributes to filter inventory data to only show the inventory records to a user that match their location. In this example, we will see how DAE can be used to mask personally identifiable information, or PII, based on the region, department, and job function of the user doing the data access request. The policies that we define will specifically allow employee PII to be visible only to managers in the HR department who are in the same region as the employee. For all other users, this information will be masked. For this example, we have three users. The first is an HR manager in the United States who will be able to view PII for US employees, but will have the PII for non-US employees masked. The second is an HR manager in Germany who will be able to view PII for German employees, but will have the PII for employees outside of Germany masked. And finally, the third user is based in the United States, but is an associate in the finance department and will have the PII masked for all employees. First, we will take a look at how this policy is defined in the NextLabs Control Center. Here we have our policy that will mask PII data. We define that the policy will mask the personal ID, or social security number, as well as the birth date. We define this policy to apply to all users, as well as the app server this should be applied to. And then we have defined two data masking conditions. one that does a partial mask of the personal ID number, and one that does a full mask of the birth date fields. Here we define that unless the country code, the user's role of HR, as well as them being a manager for their title, if all of these do not match, then the fields will be masked. This is true for both the personal ID field as well as the birth date field. Note that for both of these queries, the data is being pulled from the SAP database to dynamically apply the mask condition. Now let's go look at this in the SAP system. First, we'll see the employee data using the citizen US user, who is not a manager in the finance department. Here we can see that both the birth date as well as the personal ID is masked for all employees. Now, if we view that same data with the HR US user, who is an HR manager, we can see that for them, they are able to see the birth date and personal ID information for US employees, but for all other employees, such as those based in Germany, Great Britain, the data is masked. Now, if we view the same data table with the HRDE user, who is an HR manager in Germany, we can see that for them, they are able to see the German employee birth date information, but the personal information for the US and Great Britain users is masked. This concludes the demo of how DAE can be used to mask PII within SAP, as well as the demos of using DAE to enforce data privacy controls.